Hey guys, I'm Venkat and this is part 29 of Web Development with Blazor video series. In this video, we'll discuss some of the commonly used advanced data grid column features like column chooser, reordering columns, column resizing, and column menu. We use column chooser to show or hide data grid columns dynamically at runtime. To enable it, we need to do two things. First, set show column chooser boolean property to true and initialize toolbar property to a new string array. Now, if you recollect from our previous videos in the series, in the toolbar, if we want to display buttons for database CRUD operations like create, read, update, delete, etc., we include the respective strings like add, edit, update, delete, cancel, etc. Right now, we want to display column chooser, so we include the string column chooser. Notice, now in the toolbar, we have this columns dropdown, which we can use to dynamically show and hide data grid columns. For now, let's only display these three columns, first name, last name, and department name. Click OK. There we go. Only the selected three columns are displayed. We even have search functionality. For example, if we are displaying a lot of columns in the data grid, we can use this search functionality to search for the column that we are looking for. At the moment, in this data grid, we have got six grid columns. And by default, all these grid columns are included in the column chooser. Notice when we drop the column chooser down, we see all those six columns here. Now, what if I want to exclude a specific column? Let's say, for example, we don't want to display department name in the column chooser, and that's easy to do. All we need to do is, on the respective grid column, set this boolean property show in column chooser to false. Now, in the column chooser, notice we don't have department name column, but it is displayed in the data grid. So if we hide a column in the column chooser, then the end user will not have the ability to dynamically show or hide that specific column. It will always be displayed in the data grid. At the moment, in the data grid toolbar, we have a button for column chooser, and when we click it, the column chooser opens. We can also do exactly the same thing on a click of an external button. Let's actually do that. First, let's bring in Syncfusion buttons namespace and then include a div element here. Set padding bottom, include a button, wire up onClick event handler. Let's name it open column chooser. The content on the button is also open column chooser. Our obvious next step is to include this event handler. Let's do that in the code block right here. Private async task, the name of the event handler. In the interest of time, I've already created this property, employee grid. Notice its type, sfgrid of employee. So we are going to use this property to reference the data grid. So on the data grid itself, let's include @ref, and the value for this is our employee grid property. And then in the event handler here, on the grid, that is on employee grid property, we have open column chooser async method. This is an async method, so let's await its execution. Now, when we click the button, we have the column chooser open. Click on it again, it disappears. At the moment, we have column chooser right here, just below this columns drop-down button in the toolbar. What if we want to render this at a different location on the screen? Well, for that, we can use X and Y coordinates that are passed as parameters to this open column chooser async. Now, the important point to keep in mind is these X and Y coordinates are relative to the data grid itself. For example, let's say we want this column chooser to appear just below this button, exactly at the position where this data grid starts. So basically, we want the column chooser to align with the left and top edge of the data grid. For that, we pass 0 as the value for both X and Y coordinates. So let's actually do that, 0 for X and 0 for Y. Now, the column chooser pops up on the left-hand side. We can also reorder these grid columns at runtime by simply dragging and dropping them. And to enable column reordering, all we need to do is on the data grid, set this Boolean property, allow reordering to true. Notice, now we are able to click on a column header and drag it to the desired position in the grid. We also have a visual clue. Notice at the moment we have a visual clue between first and last name columns. So if I drop the date of birth column now, it is placed between first and last name columns. By default, we're able to reorder every column in the data grid. What if we don't want to allow a specific column to be reordered? For example, let's say we don't want to allow department name column to be reordered. Well, for that, on the respective grid column, simply set allow reordering Boolean property to false. Now, notice we are not able to drag and drop department name column. Its position in the data grid is fixed. At the moment, to reorder columns, we drag and drop. Can we do the same in code? Yes, we can. Let's actually reorder first name and last name columns. So on this button, let's change the content to reorder first name and last name columns. Let's also change the event handler name to keep it meaningful. Let's call it reorder columns. Scroll down and change the name of the event handler here as well. And on the data grid, notice we have reorder column async method, and then we specify our columns that we want to reorder. In our case, we want to reorder first name and last name columns. Notice every time we click this button, first and last name columns are reordered. Now, notice the name of this method, reorder column async. The word column is singular. Basically, we are reordering first name to last name and last name to first name, one-to-one column reordering. We also can reorder multiple columns. Basically, we can reorder first and last name columns to the position of gender column and gender column to the position of first name column. And to be able to do that, we actually have reorder columns async. The word columns is plural. And when I have the mouse over, take a look at the two parameters. From field names parameter, it's actually a list of string, which means we can specify multiple columns. Let's actually do that. We can either pass an array or a list. Let's actually pass an array. So in from fields, we have first and last name columns, and in the to field, let's specify gender. Notice now when we click this button, these two columns, first name and last name, are reordered to the position where we have this gender column. And this gender column is reordered to the position where we have this first name column. Let's actually click the button. Notice the columns are reordered as expected. SyncFusion Data Grid also allows column width to be resized dynamically at runtime. Again, same idea. To enable column resizing, simply set allow resizing Boolean property to true. Notice when I move the mouse pointer onto the right edge of any column, the pointer changes, and now I am able to increase or decrease the width of a column. At the moment, we are able to resize every column in the grid, and that's because I've set this Boolean property allow resizing to true at the data grid level. This property is also available at the grid column level. So this means if I want to exclude this specific column, in this case department name, from being resized, we simply set allow resizing on this specific grid column to false. Auto resizing is also supported. Let me actually explain what I mean. We resize a column by dragging the right edge of that column. At the moment, first name column is resized. Now, when we move the mouse pointer again to the right edge of the column, the pointer changes. And at this point, instead of dragging the column, if I simply double click, notice what happens. The column resizes. Auto resizing automatically resizes the column width to the widest cell content. On a given grid column, we can also include minimum and maximum width. And then when we actually resize that column, we are restricted to that defined minimum and maximum width. Let's actually look at this in action. Let's specify minimum width to 200 pixels and maximum width to 300 pixels on this first name column. At the moment, the minimum width of this first name column is 200 pixels and maximum is 300 pixels. Notice what happens when I try to resize this column. I am restricted by those values. I am not able to resize this column beyond those defined min and max values. Finally, column menu. It has options to integrate data grid features like sorting, grouping, filtering, column chooser, etc. To enable column menu, set show column menu boolean property to true. Now, next to every data grid column, we have these three vertical dots, and when we click on it, we see this menu here, and this is called column menu. At the moment, we have these two features, auto fit and column chooser. In addition, we also want to be able to group columns, ungroup, and filter. For that, in the code block, let me introduce a property. All these strings, that is autofit, autofit all, etc., are the features that we want in the column menu. Our next step is to tie this property to the data grid. And for that, on the data grid, we use column menu items property and then specify this property as the value. Notice now we have grouping and filtering options in the column menu, but grouping and ungrouping is disabled. Why is that? Well, that's because we did not enable grouping on the data grid. So let's allow grouping and let's also allow filtering. Finally, let's also specify filtering and grouping settings. Basically, we want to show grouped column in the data grid and we want to use a checkbox type filter. If you're new to grouping and filtering, we discuss them in detail in parts 13 and 14 of this video series. Now, when we click on the three dots, we can group data by this gender column. When the data is grouped by gender and when we click on the same three dots again, ungroup is now enabled. And when I click this, the data is ungrouped. Similarly, we can filter data as well. We have checkbox-like filter. Here is the complete list of strings that you can use to customize menu items in the data grid column menu. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.